Hello, this is Bruce Vasbiner, Director of Segment Marketing for International Truck. We're here at the 2022 NTEA Work Truck Show, and I'm standing in front of the new International eMV series. We'll walk you through a little bit of a product walk around, and I'll explain some of the applications that the vehicle's able to do at this point in time. So we'll start at the front. The very noticeable difference is the body color grille surround and body color bumper. This is standard on the eMV. You can also see that we've got a common new look with the styling of this relative to the MV series, International MV series. They're both in the same product family, so we kept the look the same. We'll continue to walk around here and talk to some of the safety features on this. We have the standard, the breakaway mirrors that have been brought out that increases visibility up along the side of the vehicle. Underneath the hood is a series of computers and basically an electric front of engine accessory drive that powers things that would normally be there in an internal combustion engine product. Still have a radiator for what I will show you in a moment is the battery thermal management system, and we'll be able to walk through some of those features. As we walk back, one of the other characteristic items is in the air intake grille, you always see this placard that says electric. So those are the very noticeable things from a customer perspective or visual out in the real world with customers. Those are the signature items for the International EMV. Continuing to walk rearward, everything on this vehicle is built with efficiency and low energy use in mind. So we've got pedestal mirrors, LED headlights, which are on the front. All this stuff is standard. And again, back to the efficiency factor with an electric vehicle. Underneath on the passenger side is the air compressor and the air tanks, which you can see. This is currently an air chassis only vehicle. It can either be ordered in a 25999 GVWR or a 33,000 class 7 GVWR rating. Continuing to work rearward, this is the charging port, which is an SAE J1772 CCS1 charging port. It can do either AC or DC charging. Continuing rearward, this is the battery thermal management system. This is a system that, like us humans, batteries like to be kept between 70 and 75 degrees. So if you're cold, it warms them up. If it's hot, it cools them down. This allows for optimal charging, also extends battery life, which ultimately affects the state of health of the batteries and the longevity of the vehicle. Continuing to work rearward, if we could pan back here to the underneath are the batteries. They're cradled between the frame rail, and then at the rear is the what I call the distribution center. This takes the power from the batteries and either routes it forward to the previously mentioned devices under the hood or rearward to the motor, which we'll get to in a moment. This system, it has a IROS or an International Ride Optimized air suspension underneath it. That is currently the only offering. We're working on some mechanical vari-rate suspensions in the not too distant future. So to get to the complete rear of the vehicle here, you can see the electric motor that's underneath. That is the propulsion system. And then there's a short drive shaft to the rear axle. As I said, we are either 25999 or 33,000 GVWR rated. And lastly, and we'll walk around to the other side and continue, but there is a lift gate on the rear, and I will show you in a moment what powers that. We got the LED headlights. Get a good picture from a perspective of those are very energy efficient and create a unique styling signature. As we walk rearward, this is a 12-volt battery system that is continuously recharged throughout the day from our chassis batteries. This is what enables the cycling of the rear lift gate. And we have another couple devices here. It can power a electrohydraulic scissor type lift, etc. So there are some straight rail applications. The most popular right now for electric vehicles is a dry van. We have wheelbases of 217, 236, 254, 272, accommodating the standard 20, 22, 24, and 26-foot dry van configurations. We can also put a stake flat or a stake flat dump on this as well. Anything straight rail that, you know, can use 12-volt power to power the bed on the back. As you can see, again, the batteries and the battery distribution in the International IROS suspension system. So we've moved into the interior of the new International EMV series. The first thing that you're going to notice is it has a lot of common interior componentry to our International EMV series, and that's intentional. We used the EMV series platform and built off of it. It has a same proven chassis from a rail perspective and axle that we use on our EMV product today. What is new, and that I wanted to highlight in here, is the new completely digital glass instrument cluster. This is unique to an EMV. It has the speed, the 12-volt battery system status, as well as the regenerative braking that is being done on a vehicle. This vehicle comes standard with 3 degrees of regenerative braking. So as you learn how to drive it, you can put a maximum amount of regenerative power back into the batteries. And as I said, it's an air chassis, so it's got the air system gauges. Very easy to start. You literally get in, you turn it on, it fires up the air compressor system, gets the air tanks full. You do a second key cycle, and then you simply put your foot on the service brake, release the parking brake, press it into drive, and you can drive down the road. So thanks for taking the time today to walk around our new International EMV series, and please come see us at a show.